Okay, so this is a joint work with Georgios Amanatidis, George Christodoulou, and Evangelos Markakis. I will start by saying some things about our topic. We study an elementary and fundamental model for allocating indivisible goods from a mechanism design viewpoint. And we basically consider a setting where a set of indivisible items have to be allocated to a set of players. So an outcome in this problem is an allocation of the items to the players. And this allocation can be seen as a partition of the items into bundles that the players get. Okay, and all these are under the context of truthful mechanism design in a setting without money. So let's see some preliminaries. We have a set of indivisible goods, a set of players, and we assume additive valuation functions. So each player has a value for each of the available items. And the total value that he derives from the total value that he derives is basically the sum of the values of the items that he gets. And an allocation is a partition of the set of items, as I said earlier. So some things about our focus. We focus on deterministic mechanism design in a setting without monetary transfers. The only restriction that we have is that all the items must be allocated by the mechanism, so no item is discarded by the mechanism. And we mainly study the case of two players, although we have also some partial results for the general case, but everything that I will state from now on has to do with the case of two players, unless stated otherwise. Now, about our contribution, initially we fully characterize truthful mechanisms for the case of two players, and we also investigate what truthfulness imposes as a restriction to the fairness domain, and we also get several tight approximation bounds for several fairness notions. And finally, we provide a new class of truthful mechanisms for the general case of n players, which is not dictatorial. Okay, so let me begin with our main result, which is the characterization. Now, in order to give you an idea on how truthful mechanisms look like, I will say that they are structured based on the following two parts. So, there is a picking part where players pick their best subject among some pre-specified choices determined by the mechanism. And there is also an exchange part where players are offered the chance to exchange certain subsets of items if it is favorable to do so. Now notice that each of these parts also defines a truthful mechanism. And so, in general, a truthful mechanism may have one of these parts or maybe a combination of these two parts, and we will see how this combination looks like in the process. Okay, so let me start with the picking mechanism, with the picking part which defines the picking mechanisms. Here, we say that the mechanism is a picking mechanism if there exists a partition of the items into two sets, set N1 and set N2. And the first one, N1, regards player 1, and N2 regards player 2. And there is also a set of offers defined on these sets, respectively. So basically, there are some subsets of items that are offered to player 1 from set N1, and some subsets of items that are offered to player 2 from set N2. And what happens here is that at every value profile, the mechanism allocates the best offer from the respective set to each player, and the other player gets the remaining items from this set. So let me give you an example here. Okay, so as you can see, we have two players. These are their valuations for each of the available items. These are the valuations for player 1, and these are the valuations for player 2. We have six items, and the first four define set N1, and the last two define set N2. And we also have a set, some sets of offers. So player one gets to choose between the house and the car and the airplane, and the train. And the second player gets to choose between the TV and the ball. So as you can see, the best offer for player one is the car and the airplane, because they have a value of 10. And the best offer for player two is the TV. So what will happen is that player one will be allocated with the car and the airplane, since this is the best offer. Player two will be allocated with the TV, since this is also his best offer from his respective set. And the rest of the remaining items from each set will go to the other player. So player two will get the house and the train, and player one will get the ball. So this is how the allocation looks like. Here are the best offers, and each player gets the remaining items from the other set. Okay, so let's proceed to the exchange part, which defines the exchange mechanisms. We say that the mechanism is an exchange mechanism if, once again, there is a partition of items into two sets, set E1 and set E2, which can now be seen as endowments to the players. And there is also a set of pairwise disjoint exchange deals. So basically, here players get the chance to exchange certain subjects from their endowment with the other player. And what happens is that at every value profile, every exchange that improves both players is performed by the mechanism, while every exchange that reduces the value of even one of the players is avoided. So let me give you an example here as well. Here we have five items, and the endowment for player one are the first three items. The endowment for player two are the last two items. And there is also a deal. Player one can exchange with player two the car and the airplane with a train. And as you can see, this deal is favorable for both players, since 7 is higher than 5, and 7 is also higher than 4. So this is how things look like before the deal. And as I said, since the deal is favorable for both players, improves both players, it will be performed by the mechanism. So this is how the final allocation looks like. OK, so now that we saw how the two parts look like, we're ready to define the picking exchange mechanisms. And the definition states that a mechanism is a picking exchange mechanism if we have a partition of the items into four sets, and the mechanism run a picking mechanism in the union of the first two sets and an exchange mechanism in the union of the last two sets. And our main theorem states that a mechanism is truthful if and only if is a picking exchange mechanism. OK, so now that we have the pool of all truthful mechanisms, we can actually answer to questions like, we have the key to answer to questions like, which of them are also fair? And of course, one can use this characterization to answer several other kind of questions, like, which of them are also neutral, or which of them are also Pareto efficient. But for the sake of the talk, I will stick to fairness. And before I proceed to fairness, I will state a crucial property that all these mechanisms have. And this comes from the notion of control. Now, we say that a player controls an item if every time he values it more than all the other items together, then he gets it. And the key lemma here, control of singletons, states that when we are talking about truthful mechanisms, every item is controlled by some player. So with that in mind, let us see some fairness notions. And there are many ways that one can define what is considered fair and what is not. I will start with the standard notions like envy-freeness and proportionality. And I will say that there are more laxed ones, like the approximate versions of envy-freeness and proportionality, envy-freeness up to an item, the maximin share, VN fairness, and others. Now, from an algorithmic point of view, we know that envy-freeness and proportionality cannot be achieved. However, we can actually achieve the relaxed notions. So the question is, what happens from a mechanism design perspective? Unfortunately, the control of singleton's property, which is actually a restriction that we do not have from the algorithmic perspective, dictates that we cannot achieve any approximation for notions like envy-freeness and proportionality. However, control of singletons seems to have no detrimental effect in the more relaxed notions, like maximin share and envy-freeness up to an item. Now, the thing here is that picking exchange mechanisms, the truthful mechanisms, allow different types of control to the players. So there are mechanisms that allow the players to have control over pairs. And by that, I mean control of sets that contain two items, or control of sets that have even more items. And what we observed was that if the mechanism gives a player this kind of power to have control over pairs, for example, then the same situation arises for the lax notions as well. Now, the good news are that there is actually hope for truthfulness and fairness, since there is a subclass of picking exchange mechanisms, namely singleton picking exchange mechanisms, that does not allow control of pairs. So we can actually achieve some things here, and I will give you some examples. We can actually achieve envy-freeness up to an item if and only if we have four or less items. And we can also achieve a 2 over m approximation for the maximin share. And actually, this is the best that we can do. So with that, I will conclude the talk about about fairness. And I will say some things about the generalization that I mentioned in the beginning of the talk. As I said, we propose a new class of truthful mechanisms for the general case of n players, which is not dictatorial. And I will not fill you with details, but I will just say that this class is defined in a recursive way and is based on the case of the two players. So basically, it can be seen as a generalization of the picking exchange mechanisms. However, we already know that this is not a characterization, and the structure here is much richer. And the thing is that the notion of control that gave us an insight on how truthful mechanisms look like for in the case of two players. Here, unfortunately, seems to not convey enough information. Okay, and I will conclude the talk with some work, some possible directions for future work. The obvious direction is for one to characterize truthful mechanisms for the general case of n players, which remains an open and fundamental problem. There are also other interesting questions, like if we can use our characterization and extend it to other models and other settings, like settings where we do not have indivisible items, but the model is continuous. So that was it. Thank you.